Restoring an image backup from one computer to another. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I have had people get downright angry when they hear my answer to this problem. And it's really a fundamental misunderstanding of exactly what image backups are for. Let's read an example question. If I want to restore an image backup from a previous computer complete with its operating system onto another computer with a different operating system, will the operating system on the backup be allowed to install and override the operating system on the other computer? If so, how do I get around this? So to be clear, this isn't a matter of allowing anything. This isn't a matter of one backup or one system allowing something to happen on the other. You can absolutely restore an image taken on one machine to another. There's no allowing to happen. It overwrites everything that's on the destination machine, on that new machine. It's all gone. It's replaced by whatever is in that backup image. Here's the problem. Probably won't work. That is because this is not what backup images are for. Let's be clear, backing up is about saving yourself from problems. It's about being able to recover when you delete a file. It's about being able to restore your machine to a known state if you happen to get malware. It's about knowing that you can replace a hard drive and carry on in case a hard drive fails. It is not intended as some kind of a shortcut for moving from one machine to another. That's not how it works. That's not what it's for. It's a safety net, not an optimization for moving. Here's the problem. When you set up Windows, when you install Windows on a machine, it configures itself for that machine. By that I mean it sets settings, it installs drivers, it includes all sorts of information that is specific to the hardware on that machine. If you then take that backup image, which contains all of those machine-specific settings, and take it to another machine and restore it, all of those machine-specific settings are going to be wrong because the hardware on the new machine is completely different than it was on the old machine and doesn't match what's inside of the backup. When that happens, when you do that, Windows will try really, really hard. God bless it, it will. It really tries hard to work. There are, I'll call them, three possible outcomes. One is it'll fail. It just won't work. The machine won't boot. The machines are so dramatically different from one another that Windows just doesn't stand a chance. It's just not going to work. Another alternative is that it'll kind of work mostly, but it'll be unstable and problems are going to become apparent pretty quick and programs won't run and it'll complain about hardware and there'll be error messages that you can't explain. In other words, again, Windows will try and it'll actually start running, but there will be many, many problems because of the differences in hardware. The third scenario is actually the scarier one to me. Because in the first two scenarios, it's obvious. Things aren't working or things aren't working right. The third scenario is where you restore your image backup to this new machine, you boot it up, and it kind of sort of looks like it worked. Well, you still don't know. It may not actually be touching software or hardware that is actually fundamentally broken, because you're not using it in the same way, or you're doing something different, or you just haven't gotten around to exercising that particular piece of the machine's capabilities. So a day, a week, a month, or two later, you suddenly realize that, oh, this X doesn't work, and I have no way to fix it. And it doesn't work because the image that I restored to this machine never had support for that, because it wasn't part of the first machine. So you're still left with a fundamentally incomplete system that hasn't been properly set up for the hardware that you're on. Again, that's not what image backups are for. Now, I do have to be honest, sometimes there are scenarios where it can work. What has to happen for it to work is that the motherboard between the two machines needs to be similar. What does it mean to be similar? I can't tell you, because we don't know what the differences are that are going to matter to Windows. The more similar they are, the better. Identical is best, of course, but we know that that's not always an option. For individual devices that may be connected to that system, the same thing applies. The more similar the devices are between old and new, the better the chances of things working. How similar? Again, we have no way to really know. And of course, individual devices that are attached to the system need to be optional. Because if this optional device stops working, well, you're at least still running Windows. But if the device is required, like it's the hard disk or the CPU or the RAM or something that's on the motherboard, it's not optional. It's got to work or your system won't work. Where this actually does play out is when large companies buy dozens, if not hundreds, of identical machines. Then, absolutely, an image backup from one machine can then get replicated out to all these hundreds of other machines, and they boot up and they're pre-installed and pre-configured and everything is ready to go. In reality, they tend to use more dedicated tools for that kind of thing, but in theory, they could do exactly the same thing with an image backup because the machines are all identical. But it's that identicalness that they can count on, and it's that identicalness that you very likely don't have. So, what should you do instead? What you might expect, when you get a new machine, install Windows from scratch, if it didn't already come with Windows installed from scratch. Install your applications from scratch so that they'll be set up properly. Restore your data. This is where your image backup can come in handy, because your image backup, by definition, has everything on it. Everything including your data. So you know that you didn't forget a file, you just need to copy it from the image backup wherever it may be located within that image. You're not restoring the entire image, you're just restoring the individual files, folders, and data that you care about. That's platform independent and would then work with the software that you've installed on the operating system you've installed. Now, the other thing is that there are tools that try to solve this problem. There have been for basically as long as Windows has been changing revisions, people have been writing tools that try to solve this very problem. I've used them. I actually restored a copy of Windows Vista from the machine of a friend of mine into a virtual machine of my own. This allowed me to confirm that things were working or recover files or understand settings or do various things with that machine in the virtual machine environment, which by definition is dramatically different than the original piece of hardware that the operating system came from. I used a tool called Redeploy, which is a feature of Macrium Reflect's paid edition, I believe it is. And it kind of sort of worked, was not 100% successful. And therein lies my concern. There are going to be fringe things that aren't going to work. You can spend an awful lot of time with a partially working system that just frustrates you, or you keep trying to find solutions for problems that result as part of the migration. Why spend all that time? Why deal with potentially the extra expense of another tool? Why not do the right thing? The right thing, of course, is to reinstall Windows from scratch on your new hardware so that it can configure itself for the specifics of that machine and work reliably. Certainly more reliably than I would trust any approach of actually moving an image backup from one machine to another. I hope that was helpful. I hope that clarifies why this is such an issue. It's not something that I would take on lightly, for sure. If at all possible, reinstall Windows and move forward from there. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/4751. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.